That's right. Tonio K's new album, Life in the Food Chain, is 100% polyvinyl chloride, paper, and music. Just the thing for a hungry family like yours. Is a production of Full Moon Records on Epic Records and Tape.
WHFS, would you please welcome Epic Full Moon Recording Artist Tonio K.
Little bit, give me one day older, or tomorrow, luck, tomorrow, better think of Situation wherein your mother was there to protect you, your papa was there to provide. So how in the world did the excellent babies wind up in these hotels? Some broken inside, you lie on your bed in the midnight dark, listening to every sound, watching the shadows for anything moving in, hoping they don't come around. But that's a call we do, and this is a cat and mouse. You know that it's watch your step and you cross yourself and you get back in the house. And it's a call we do, it's pushing sure. And their job isn't quite enough. That's right, we're talking about the good life in the food chain. Love among the ruins. I guess that you finally come to accept there's just nothing you can do about it. It's kind of like carving the turkey. Kind of like mowing that lawn. Everything gets to this certain dimension, winds up on a customer's big man down. Down we go, that's the cat bowing. You know that it's cut the cake and then grab a plate. It's kind of like carving the turkey. It's kind of like winds up on a customer's plate, man. Almost as if by magic, gone, 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 gone. Where is it gone and what can we do about it? What are the alternatives? Let's discuss that.
Let's see if God loves.
exactly what this song's about then. Kennedy influenced field melodrama. Little Willis Caesar, he was in trouble. He was a running like a bandit through his longest, darkest night. All that really lacked, in fact, was the shovel. Then he could've dug himself his own grave and saved everybody some time. 'Cause you don't relieve the union boys of their payroll. Not unless you've got an army ready to fight. And when the union representatives were unable to reach a suitable agreement, well, that's when Willie took a flight. Come on, little Caesar, you can make it. Anyway, you're gonna have to try. You don't ever tangle with the ruling class unless you're prepared to take it, because they can't kiss you down from now until 1999. And the question, of course, becomes, why did he try to put the cat in the freezer? And what does that mean? Let's discuss it. Well, it crashed the gate at Rose's Cantina. No, not the one where Marty shot that kid. Train wreck, except it was cleaner. Everything was either out of order or fairly well hidden. Way back in the corner sat the pig man. He was the champion of the luckless, lunchless, faceless little folks, you and me, you know what I mean? And Willie, he explained the whole situation. Big man's on the phone. He's singing, come on, little Caesar, you can make it. Anyway, you're gonna have to try. You don't ever tangle with the ruling class unless you're prepared to take it. Because they can't kiss you down from now until 1999. Here's why. The whole thing is over. Everybody wants to negotiate. Big man, order three more glasses de cola. Willie worries, how can I repay? Big man says, if you ever down around Diego, look me up. You know that I'm not that hard to find. And with that, stands and leaves the table. Or just lay down. You don't ever tangle with the ruling class unless you're quite prepared to take it, because they can't dish it out from now until 1 9 and then 2 more 9s. I said, oh, come on, little Caesar, you can get it.
Come on, Caesar.
Anyway, you're gonna have to try. But just don't ever tangle with that ruling class unless you're prepared to take it out on the road. They can and will dish it out from now until the end of time. Hey. It's the circus. Come on, little Caesar, join the circus. As I come on, you don't see so you can. Come on, come on.
Thank you.
Okay, so now we have dealt with Life in the Food Chain, the first half of this evening's performance. And we're ready to move on to Love Among the Ruins, which is indeed a function of Life in the Food Chain. Beginning fittingly enough with American Love Affair.
It's some American underwear.
Okay, you're probably already wondering what an acoustic guitar is doing in a set like this. Not to mention a 12-string. The significant differences are that this acoustic guitar here is chrome, if you'll notice, and that's Earl Slick playing the 12-string, so who knows what could happen. Continuing on with our Love Among the Ruins trilogy, we find that the insults and the punches flew, just like they always had. I knocked her down, strictly symbolically, and left the room. But she came running back. And I said, hey, look around. Hey, look in your mirror. Lay your ego down. It'll get so much clearer. Why continue to push? Punish each other. Wouldn't it be so much easier to just find another lover? Now you're feeling cold. Hey, babe, I'm on fire. And I'm losing control. Because you got no desire. And so we go sparring through the night like two lightweight contenders. The flames has gone out. Let's extinguish the embers. Put up the flag and lay down your weapon. This perpetual battle royal is a long way from heaven. Call it a mistake or call it whatever. Let's just call it off. Better late than never. I got you. You have got me, but we collectively got no manners at all. We're still counting down to ecstasy when some criticizes all this situation wrong. And that's so hard. So you keep the car and all the passionate letters. They won't get you that far. They will not make it no better. And baby, someday, some other time, we can try this again. Maybe someday these flaming hearts will learn how to be friends. But right now, put up the flag and lay down your weapon. This perpetual battle royal is a long way from heaven. Call it a mistake or call it whatever. Let's just call it off. Better late than never. Lay down your head. This perpetual battle royal is a long way from heaven. Call it a mistake or you call it whatever. Let's just call it off. Better late than never. Put up the flag and lay down your weapon. Why don't you put up the flag and just lay down your weapon? Baby, put up the flag. Quite simple. discipline and just lay it on down. Lay it on down. Begin the 60s. Hey. Anybody in here has got anything they'd like to say to anybody out in HFS land, go ahead and yell because we're recording this and it's going out live over the air, but try and keep it clean. We found that a lot of audiences like to discuss disco in the various clubs we've been at. What do you guys think of disco? If you had to capsulize it in a phrase, what would you say? You're right, it's unanimous. Okay, now, we just finished putting up the flag and laying down the weapon, but that doesn't always happen. Because if you just think about it, it's hard, doubly hard, triply hard here in the closing quarter of the 20th century to keep a relationship going. Probably not too many people in the audience out there, and to my knowledge, not too many of us here on stage, except Pa Slick, have had a relationship going for more than a couple of years, you know, outside. It's usually a night, a week, whatever, and gone. That's because too many people aren't willing to put up the flag and lay down their weapon. They're much more inclined to pick up the 2x4, the length of pipe, the 38 special next to the bedroom and the dresser. And rather than carry on a meaningful dialogue with the lover, they'll duke it out. Thus, that's why we find that a great many of our relationships wind up, if not in divorce court, in the criminal courts, homicide, manslaughter, etc. And if you just think about it, if each and every one of us, when we're inclined to hit the lover, club the lover, beat the lover, kill the lover, if we would just turn to that person, if the party of the first would turn to the party of the second and say something like this, we'd have a much more healthy society. Something like, baby, don't leave me here alone. Don't break our happy home. Think of the children. Got no kids, but think of if we did, it would surely upset them. Well, then try and think about me. Think about heartbreak, misery. Can I get a little help? Think about all the things that we've been through. Or think about how a cast would look on you. Sweetheart!
Thank you. Down, shoot 'em right on down.
the luck that we had. Lost in the park after dark when the army arrived. They were sweeping the town, chasing renegades down. There was no friends to be found. There was no place at all left to hide. Oh yes, and the Austrian son, he was having some fun. He'd been put in command of the camps, and his prisoners all died. Meanwhile, way across town in the penthouse suite of the very tallest building, the boss was asleep when he heard such a clatter. He sprang from his bed just to see what was the matter. Looked down on the street, and that scene filled his eyes. But you know, he wasn't even surprised. Quite to the contrary, he just got on the phone, and he ordered some thunder, some rain, and some disco to plow it all under. Someone asked why. With a sigh, he explained that the fiends was up doing it again. Meanwhile, back out on the street, this clown in a gown with a hat and tattoos on his shoulders comes over and whispers, "It's gonna be all right." He swears that he's a personal friend of the boss, and then he asks if we got in a sheep he can sacrifice later that night. He said no, he said oh, and I want to shatter some strange sound alive as I wave on his wound in the sky. And Sam and Attila, they was getting their fill of the action and danger. They burned every major in town. Yes, and oh, John's eyes were hazy, he must have gone crazy. He's going around trying to drown everybody he found.
We're gonna do one more anyway, we just needed a rest. Okay, we've been pretty loud tonight, so try and bring it down a little bit with something mellow. Perhaps a love song. What's all this here? What's all this I hear about hatred? I mean, what kind of a sentiment is that? Okay. You guys all know this is coming. Those of you that don't will be surprised. Now I know it's not unusual. It's nothing so unique. There's probably hundreds of wonderful love affairs that go bad in our land every week. It's a big land, but all of them others, them sad-hearted lovers, could cry in their beer, what the hate. It didn't concern me, was none of my business. I never had nothing to say, but suddenly, darling, the table has turned. You have left me for somebody new. And now it's hard to express the resentment I feel for the years that I've wasted on you. Now you can see how this has broken half of the rhythm section and the lead guitarist up. So maybe to try and pull all of us out of this, we should try and put it another way. Maybe even we should count it off in German. I don't know. I know it's not unusual. It's nothing so unique. There's probably hundreds of wonderful love affairs that go bad in this town every week. But all of them others, them sad-hearted mothers, could cry in their beer with the hay. Didn't concern me with none of my business. I never had nothing to say. Oh, suddenly, darling, the table has turned. You have left me for somebody new. And now it's hard to express the resentment I feel for the years that I've pissed away on you. I'm so full of H-A-G-R-E-G. I'm bitter and malign. I'm also P-I-S-S-E-D. You know I'm angry most of the time. Why don't you G-O-T-O-N-G-O-L-L trap people like the revenge? I'm going to K-I-L-L. One of us, baby, at a time. And I'll decide on which. But wait a minute. I know I'm acting immature. I'm acting like a child. I should display some self-control instead of going wild like this, and I wish I could. Except all this is simply life, which includes pain. Act upon the actual fact that nobody's to blame. Oh, yes, I wish I was as mellow as, for instance, Jackson Brown. But found the sorrow, found the fucker. I hope you wind up in a crowd. I'm so full of H-A-G-R-E-T. I'm bitter, I'm alive, I'm also E-I-S-S-E-D. You know I'm angry most of the time. Why don't you G-O-T-O H-E-double-L trap your pig for K-I-L-L. One of us, baby, in the time. And I'll decide on which. I am so full of H-A-G-R-E-T. I'm bitter, I'm alive, I'm also E-I-S-S-E-D. You know I'm angry just about most of the time. Why don't you G-O-T-O H-E-double-L the trap before you get on the door knock? Okay, I don't know. What I'm afraid of the time. And I'll decide on which I'm so full of. Yeah. Yeah. G-O-T-O G-O-T-O H-E-double-L. You try to get on the door knock. You try to get on the door knock. You try to get on the door knock. What's that smell? It's a juvenile way to end the show, but what the hell, it's fun.
This is WHFS Bethesda, Maryland. We'd like to thank the following people for tonight's live broadcast from the Bayou. All the people down at the Bayou. The folks at Full Moon Records. John DeVarian. Jerry Thompson. The folks from Sonority Recording. Roger Bird and Bill Brahms. And also Chris Kelly. All for making tonight's performance possible. And thank you for listening.